And welcome back here to the Fortin Center as we get set for our men's action here tonight. As we had a great women's game and Rocky coming out with the win there. And we'll turn it over to the men's side of things now. And I look for an equally good game here, Kyle. I think it's going to be a defensive battle.
Yeah, both teams.
Both
teams coming in with a record of 3-4 in conference play. Tech with a record of 13-6 overall. The Battling Bears, a record of 12-7, and the Bears looking to bounce back after that loss at home against Carroll on Thursday. It'll be interesting to see how they do against this Ordeger team.
Yeah, you know, and Coach Adam Hyatt was at West Mini for a lot of years, and, you know, stress defense there, and he's definitely coaching defense here at Montana Tech as well. So, you know, it's going to be a battle. Rocky struggled the other night. Their starters only scored 15 points total for the ball game, you know, and you're not going to win many games in the Frontier Conference doing that for sure. So
no.
But go over a little bit over the conference standings. Kyle touched on it a little bit. Cody can throw them up on the screen there. Carroll College leading the way with a 7-1 mark. That one loss coming here at Rocky. LC with a 4-3 mark as well as MSU Northern. And then you have Tech, Providence, and Rocky all at 3-4, and Montana Western at 1-6. So once again, it's a logjam. So we'll wait and see what happens here tonight. You know, Northern is at LC playing tonight, so we'll see what happens there. And these are huge games here, or this is a huge game here tonight, I think, for these two ball clubs.
Yeah, spots 2 through 6. Are within a game of each other, with Carroll, of course, sitting on top at 7-1, and then at the bottom is Montana Western with a record of 1-6.
And back on January 5th, it was 75-67. Tech got the win up there in the Hyper Center in Butte. So, you know, just I thought, you know, it's kind of weird because these teams come in here averaging, you know, 85, 90 points a game, and the you see two teams like this, they end up in the 60-70 point range, and you know that it's always fun to watch the defense, and for me anyway, and they definitely played it there. We'll take us a little bit of a break here, come back, and if we can't get Coach Dreikosen, we'll just keep right on talking. You want to go yell at him, Kyle?
Hey, gave somebody my chair. I didn't know.
We're not going to give that chair away, Coach.
Yeah. What's up?
Well, here there's a basketball game going on tonight.
Yeah, there always is in the Fortin Center this time of year.
Yeah, you know, I'm impressed with the crowds, man. We were full the other night, and another nice crowd in here tonight. But, Coach, more importantly, tough loss the other night against Carroll, and got to bounce back tonight against a very good defensive-minded Tech team.
Yeah, no, they just play so hard. They're the hardest playing team in the league, so they're hard to play against. And what we're struggling with is offense. We had five starters score 2 points in the last 36 minutes against Carroll. I don't think I've ever had that in my entire life. Not when you got an All-American in your starting lineup and, you know, possibly another All-Conference player and, you know, that kind of thing. But either way, you know, give Carroll credit. I thought we played good enough defense in that game going back. You know, I know we're not talking about that. We got to talk about tonight. But our offense, we just couldn't get going. And, you know, tonight, if you can't get your offense going, it's going to be tough because their defense is so good, you know.
Yeah.
And but we worked on it. And, you know, we'll see what we come out with. We're excited about it. We got a positive practice in yesterday. And I like our guys' attitude coming into today.
Good, good. So what do you think against this Tech team? I mean, we talk about their defense. Coach Hyatt's always been defensive-minded, but what do you think of this program in his second year?
Yeah. No, you know, are doing a good job. You know, anytime you take over a program, you got to get more and more of your type of guys and get your system in. And I'm sure he feels like he's doing just that. And they got some good kids. And like I said, they play hard and they got some different weapons. And, you know, they got a little bit of size, but they just got a lot of toughness. That's what they got.
And Rocky, as you said, scoring-wise, and I mentioned in the post-game, Coach, our starters, I think, had 15 points total in the ball game. And
yeah, but 2 points in the last 36 minutes.
Yeah, yeah.
15 points sounds like a lot.
It does.
Two.
When you look at it like that.
But why did I play them for the last 36 minutes? No. They should have been getting water for guys, and they know that.
But remember, you only need one more tonight.
Yeah, that's right. It's 0-0 right now, and you know, this is the game we're really focused on, not on that one on Thursday.
All right. Good luck, Coach.
Okay, thanks a lot. Hi to the people out there listening, my family and my dad and sister and Georgina and Bruce. I know you're out there listening, so take care.
All right. Thanks, Coach. And Coach Dreyke goes in there. just about had me laughing there going over that. But, yeah, very tough game offensively the other night for the Battling Bears. 15 points out of his five starters, and, as he said, 2 points in the last 36 minutes or whatever. But, you know, just a tough night for the Bears. And we'll take us a little break here, come back. We'll get you our starters and our second game here tonight in about 5 minutes.
She didn't know there were two games. I thought they were just hanging low. Evening. She's like, well, I was planning on dinner.
You need to go. Go. I'm fine.
She said 30 minutes.
Yeah, you got to go.
I probably should.
Yeah, you bet. Well, anytime you're down, you want to.
Okay.
No
And welcome back to the Fortin Center here on the campus of Rocky Mount College. We get set for our men's game. In our first one, we had the Lady Bears, Battling Bears from Rocky Mountain College coming out on top in that one by the score of 74-53. In a great back and forth, especially the first half. That game, we had 13 lead changes in that first half, so it was definitely a back and forth ball game. Looking for another good one here on the men's side. As we said earlier, Tech won back in January the 5th, just a couple weeks ago, up in Butte by the score of 75-67 in that one. So we get set for our starting lineup here tonight. First of all, for the Ordagers from Montana Tech and head coach Adam Hyatt, it'll be number one, Nate Ward, a 6-foot sophomore. Well, excuse me, I guess we're going to back up and do our national anthem. Excuse me there. As the flags will be presented, we'll stand up and we'll have that. And we'll turn it over to the PA announcer. And now we'll get to those starters for tonight's contest. For the Ordagers and Adam Hyatt, it'll be number one, Nate Ward, a 6-foot sophomore out of University Place, Washington. Number five will be Dylan Panabecker, a 6'4 junior out of Shoto, Montana. Number 20 is Taylor Ingram, a 6'7 sophomore from Helena. And number 30 is Darius Collins, a 6'4 sophomore out of Missoula. And I believe I forgot number three, Troy Owens, a 6'2 junior out of Sacramento, California. And the starting lineup tonight for the Battling Bears and Coach Bill Dreikosen, assisted by Sean McKeon, James Bullock, and Len Wilkins. It'll be number three, Brandon Naboy, 5'9 sophomore from Box Elder, Montana. Number 22 is Danny Betcher, a 6'7 senior from Billings, Montana. Number 24 will be Craig Wilmore, a 6'3 senior from Daytona Beach, Florida. Number 33 is Lucas Vining, a 6'4 junior out of Great Falls, Montana. And number 34 is Jared Samuelson, a 6'7 junior from Billings, Montana. And Rocky will be in their gold uniforms, green numbers, and Tech will be in their black uniforms tonight with their copper numbers. Coming up at halftime, we'll have the new football coach, head coach, Coach Stutzerim will be on the air with us. We'll chat with him a little bit as we get set for this one. It's going to be Collins going up against Betcher, and Betcher's going to get it in. Brandon DeBoy will bring it up across the timeline. We're underway here on the men's game. Just starting as Vining has it. Tech coming out man-to-man defense. Goes to Samuelson. Jared with it. Tries to go baseline to Betcher. Betcher puts it on the floor, goes up, shots up in the paint, is good by Danny Betcher. And Danny Betcher gets the Bears on the board first here. Diggers come back the other way. Ward with the basketball. Pannebecker. Out of Schottel, dumps inside. It's going to be stolen by Wilmore. And Craig will bring it up the floor. Craig takes it to the hole, puts it up easy off the glass. It's good. Two for Craig Wilmore. And the Bears jump out to a 4-0 lead here. Ward has it. Goes to Pannebecker. Pannebecker goes up ahead to England. Get my bearing straight here. Pannebecker swings it back to Collins. Collins puts up the three. No good. Rebound comes down. And Pannebecker is going to be whistled for the foul. Rocky comes back the other way. Brandon DeBoy with it in the paint, has it knocked loose and kicks it out to Viney. Betcher with it, goes to Wilmore. Wilmore, free throw line, nowhere to go. Kicks it back out to Viney, 7 on the shot clock. They lob it into Samuelson, and it's going to be stolen away on the backside. Nice defense there by Taylor England. As Ward comes back, goes to Collins. Collins with it to Ward. Ward on the right side. Ward looks to penetrate, dumps it off inside to England. Back outside to Owens. England with it, gets it in the paint, goes up. Shots no good. Rebound comes down to Owens. And Owens is going to be fouled inside as Lucas Vining is going to pick up the personal foul. Carson Doomer coming into the ball game. He'll replace Taylor England as Tech will inbound the basketball underneath their own basket. Out to Collins. Collins with it. Pannebecker over to Owens. Owens might have got away with a double dribble there, but it was a quick one. Ward with it. Ward going against Brandon DeBoy. Gets in the paint. Up against a tree. Throws it up. No good. Rebound fought for. Samuelson comes down with it. And they get it out to Brandon DeBoy. Quickly up to Craig Wilmore. He has it slapped away. And Doomer comes away and gets it to Ward. Ward comes quickly back the other way. Goes up. He's going to be fouled by Brandon DeBoy. Nate Nate Ward will go to the line here to shoot some free throws. And Ward will get the first one to fall as the Diggers get on the board here. Rocky on top, 4-1. And Ward gets them both to go. 4-2 is our score. Brandon DeBoy has it. Tech putting on full court pressure here. Betcher with the basketball. They get it back to the boy. Up ahead to Craig Wilmore. Divining back to Wilmore. Inside the Betcher. It's going to be knocked loose as Collins gets a hand on it, gets a steal. Goes to Owens. Owens with the basketball. Goes up, and it's partially blocked in there by Samuelson. He kicks it out to Ward, and it'll go out of bounds off of Tech. And Ladine will come in for Wilmore. Brandon DeBoy with the basketball goes to Betcher. Betcher to Ladine. Ladine had some threes the other night. He kicks it off to Vining. They dump it into Samuelson. Out to Betcher. Betcher puts up the three. Danny Betcher for three. He has 5 points in the ball game. Rocky up by 5-7-2. Owens with the basketball, brings it across, goes to Ward. Ward up the right side. Owens inside. Doomer puts up the 15-footer, good by Carson Doomer. Brandon DeBoy brings it back for the Batlin Bears. He'll go against Ward. To the Ladine, cross to Betcher. Betcher puts up another three, no good. Vining with the rebound. Lucas started his college career at Montana Tech. Out to Ladine, and Ladine's gonna be long back iron. Rebound comes down to Collins. He'll hand it off, Ward will bring it up. Now they go to Collins. Collins puts up the 17-footer, it's good. Troy. Not sure who made that. Owens, I thought. Betcher comes back the other way for the Bears. He can't complete the reverse. And the Diggers come back the other way. Austin Payne will come in. Next dead ball for the Batlin Bears. As Ward goes up, we got a whistle and a foul. As Brandon DeBoy is going to pick up his second personal foul. Satchel McDonald will come in as well for the Bears. Blake Dittman will come in for the Ordiggers. Nate Ward gets the first one as he goes 3 for 3. And we're tied at 7. Nate Ward, second one, it's going to use all the iron, fall in. He goes 4 for 4, has 4 points, and Tech takes the lead, 8-7. Timeout on the floor by Montana Tech. It'll be a 30. It'll be Rocky basketball in the backcourt. Austin Payne and Satchel McDonald came into the ballgame. Austin Payne will inbound the ball here. Got a little confusion here on the last time out, I think. Not sure what the holdup here. And we're finally back to live action here as Ladine gets the inbounds pass, goes to McDonald. McDonald comes back to Ladine, quickly up to Austin Payne. Payne back to Ladine. Ladine will set things up here on the left side. Ladine goes to Samuelson. Jared back to Ladine. They dump underneath to Satchel McDonald. It'll stay with the Bears out of bounds. And Satchel McDonald throws it off the back of a Tech player and gets it back, puts it up. He's going to be fouled. As Carson Doomer is going to pick up the personal foul, Satchel McDonald gets the basket. He'll go to the line for the old-fashioned three-point play here. Satchel's pulled that trick several times in the last couple years. And he gets the free throw to fall as well. Rocky on top, 10-8. As Lucas Finding nearly gets a steal. It'll be out of bounds. Tech ball in the backcourt on the far side. And they get it into Nate Ward. Ward with it. Ward, they get it up ahead. Inside, now they swing it back. Shot is going to be up, no good. Austin Payne goes high for the rebound, gets it out to Ladine. Ladine up the left side, skip pass to Vining. Vining with it, goes to Samuelson. Samuelson with it on top. Samuelson takes it in. Floater off the glass in front of the basket. And Jared Samuelson gets his first 2 points of the night as Ward comes back the other way for the Ore Diggers. Ward goes far side to Owens. Pannebecker with it. Back out to Ward. Ball's on the floor. Now it's kicked around. Shot is going to be put up. No good. That shot put up by Dittman. And the Batlin Bears with the rebound, 13:30 to go. Bears get it up ahead to Satchel McDonald. They swing it around, Samuelson to Vining. Vining with it, fadeaway jumper, and it's Austin Payne with the rebound. It'll be out of bounds off of the Ore Diggers. Drew Hughes coming into the floor the first time as Darius Collins coming back in. Craig Wilmore coming in. And Betcher for the Batlin Bears as Ladine will pull the trigger and inbound the basketball here for the Bears. And it'll be off of the Bears. It'll be turnover to the Ore Diggers. Rocky on top, 12-8, 13-15 to go. Christian Jones into the ballgame for the Ore Diggers. Hughes with the basketball. They get it back out on top to Jones. Hughes, far corner to Ward. Ward with it. Hughes has it. Has it knocked away from behind. And it'll be a foul on Ladeen. Hughes gets it into Ward. Ward has it out on top. Jones. Jones looks to penetrate. Free throw line jumpers, no good. Rebound comes down to Craig Wilmore. And Wilmore quickly up to Ladeen to McDonald. Satchel McDonald hits a long three-pointer. Satchel with 6 points on the night. He has 2 three-pointers. One the old-fashioned way and one the new way, I guess. 15-8, Rocky on top. 12:34 to go here in the first half. Tech basketball in the backcourt. They get it in. Hughes has it on the far side. Hughes goes to Collins. Now they get it inside. England goes up. No good. Rebound Betcher. Out to McDonald. Satchel will bring it up the right side. Gets it inside to Austin Payne. Payne, step back. Baseline jumpers. Good by Austin Payne. Austin Payne gets his first points of the night as the Ordiggers quickly get the ball up the floor as Nick Fitz has it. Fitz goes far side. Collins. Collins pulls up. Three-pointers, no good. Craig Wilmore goes high for the rebound, and Ladeen brings it up, gets it to Satchel. They go to Betcher. Betcher with it on the baseline, left side. Goes outside to Wilmore. Wilmore to Ladeen. Ladeen, three-pointer is going to be long. And rebound comes down to England. England up to Hughes to Fitz. Fitz with it, trying to make something happen. Hands off to England, now back to Fitz, and Nick Fitz hits the long three-pointer. His first points of the night, 17-11. 11:09 to go here in the first half. Rocky on top. Satchel McDonald. Satchel takes it to the hole, and he's going to have it stolen away by Collins. Collins comes back the other way. Goes up, no good. Rebound by Satchel McDonald as Ladeen will bring it back. McDonald hands off to Wilmore. Grant Wallace will come in for the Bears on the next dead ball. Skip pass goes to Ladeen. Ladeen, three-pointer, and Clayton Ladeen hits the deep three on the left side. Diggers come back. England's going to hand it off to Hughes, to Collins. Underneath, shot is up, no good. And that was Owens. Collins with the shot, excuse me. Satchel McDonald walks it across. 10:08 to go here in the first half. Satchel set things up. Goes to Austin Payne. Payne, baseline jumper. It's going to be long off the back iron. No good. Rebound comes down to Owens. Owens with the basketball up the floor. Nowhere to go in the corner. Kicks it out to Hughes. Hughes puts it on the floor. Kicks to Collins. Collins, three-pointer, no good. Rebound England. Now out to Owens. And Owens gets the three-pointer. His fifth point of the night. Timeout. Coach Dreikosen. 9:35 to go here in the first half. Rocky on top, 20-14. All right, you're here. I'll see you later.
Good. This brings back my college days. This is easy.
9:35 to go in this first half, 2014 Rocky. And I'm joined here by our new play-by-play announcer and head football coach, Mr. Chris Stutzring. Coach, how's it feel to be back at Rocky?
Great, great. Love this place when I was here for just over 2 years, and so excited and happy to be back as the head football coach.
As Ladine has the basketball on the far side, gets it into Wallace to Wilmore. And we're going to have a whistle and a travel as Craig is going to turn it over, and it'll come back to the Ordiggers. Well, it's good to see you back.
Well, thank you. I'm glad to be here, and what a great atmosphere tonight.
Yeah,
we got a big win, and
Couple of good crowds. We had a great crowd the other night. I mean, we were full house, I think, pretty much. People standing around all the way around, and you got people looking at you.
Yeah,
there.
We got the player section over there, so they're going to get really excited when they see all the coaches competing here in a little bit.
Yeah, they're probably all over there trying to pull up the video on their phones so they can hear you.
That's right. That's right. I better not say anything bad about them.
Yeah, great atmosphere with the crowd here. You know, and it's great here to have the football players and the soccer players and the skiers and all those other athletes support each other here at Rocky Mountain College. As that basket by Carson Doomer, he picks up his fourth point of the night. But it just adds to the whole atmosphere, and it's great that I know you coaches preach that to support the other sports in the programs.
Oh, absolutely. You know, the big thing, that's huge for – you know, a smaller campus like this. You don't see this at bigger campuses. You know, all these athletes know each other. They hang out. It doesn't just mean football and basketball and separate. They do a great job of being around each other and supporting each other. And it helps when a lot of the teams are really, really good.
And every once in a while, you got to call on one of those soccer players to come in and kick an extra point.
That's right. That was we're not trying to have that happen anymore. But what a great job by that guy to come in and step up and do that.
Grant Wallace getting a big steal on the baseline down there underneath, and comes back as Ladine has it. Looking for Betcher on the back door, and it's going to go out of bounds. You want to try some play-by-play?
I don't know if I know their name. I'm 24 to 2 and 2 to 7. No, this was actually my internship in college. I was sports broadcasting. My internship was with the Sioux City Bandits, an indoor football team.
All right.
And it was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun with it. And I always say that the guys who have the best jobs are the ones that can critique everything and not have to worry about the repercussions of bad play calls or anything like that. So, no, I really enjoyed it. I love coming to these games, and the women's as well. I think our coaches, the rest of the coaches on staff, doing a phenomenal job. And really, at every sport, you see all the athletes playing hard, competing hard, that you don't see at all the other schools a lot of times.
Well, talk about coaches. How's that staff coming together?
Good, good. We've got everybody but one guy here right now. We'll have another defensive backs coach here in probably about a week or 10 days. But everybody else is here. It's been a whirlwind. We have coaches from the previous year here. Which is a good mix of a couple new guys. We had two guys get in yesterday, and so we put them right to work and had a recruiting weekend this weekend. So I don't know how many questions they could answer, but, you know, it shows what kind of people they are. And coaches, they had a lot of information that they looked up on their own to find out about the school and program that they didn't know. But we've got two guys on staff that are Billings natives, which always helps. And every coach on staff has either won a national championship or multiple conference championships.
All right. And, you know, you talk about them just getting on campus and everything, and I kind of had to help a couple of them out upstairs today. They were lost trying to find a door to get out of the building.
That's right. We're trying to tell them to get recruits and show them around, and they don't even know where to go.
Tech's going to inbound the basketball underneath their basket as – it is Owens going up, misses that one, and Grant Wallace comes down with the big board, gets it up ahead to Martell. Martell, now they get it into Betcher. Back door, baseline cut.
Play.
Nice move by Craig Martell. Nice. Isaac Martell, I mean.
Boy, we're long. That's good to see. We got a good mixture of speed and athleticism and good play right there. That's a hustle play. Oh, that's a foul.
And it's going to come back. And
oh, yeah.
We're going to have the flush by Craig Wilmore. That even got the football players up and jumping around there. Yeah, Craig definitely can bring some electricity to the crowd when he gets in the open. But just a great play there by Clayton Ledeen to get that steal. But, Coach, you got your first recruiting weekend then probably, huh?
That was last weekend was number one that we had with three coaches here. So that was tough. And this weekend we actually have two. We had one Friday and Saturday. And then because of Martin Luther King Day, you know, a lot of these guys that we're recruiting are two-sport athletes.
Right.
And we encourage that. We love that. But with that comes, hey, coach, we play on Friday, Saturday night, Saturday afternoon. So the ability to have a visit on Sunday and Monday with no school has really helped us. So we'll pull double duty this weekend, but that's all right. We're going to do whatever we got to do to get the best people and best players here.
Well, coach, let's talk about, you know, you got coming back on conference championship you just won, and your press conference when first one there, you said you wouldn't be, I won't say what you said, but you said you said you wouldn't be very smart if you changed anything.
Yeah.
So. But,
yeah.
Talk a little bit about, I mean, you're familiar with it, the team and the players. You recruited a lot of these kids. Just talk about these kids you got coming back.
I actually knew everybody on roster that was coming back except for two guys. And they just came in as transfers right before the season started, but just a great group of kids. You know, I've been other places where the head coach or coach's phones ring off the hook on Friday, Saturday nights, and we don't have that issue here. I think our guys are respectful. They're good students. They're good people, and it just helps that they're great athletes and on top of it. And you look across the – as we're looking right now at all of them, there's guys from seven different states sitting on the front row together. And they care about each other, they hang out with each other, and they do a phenomenal job when we have recruits on campus. We do what's called a player panel where basically we say, hey kids, you know, some of you players come up and at 8 o'clock and we're going to have parents and recruits ask you any questions, and we need a few guys. Last night we had 42 players show up.
Well, that's great, yeah.
So that's huge, and to be able to have guys that are bought in, and, you know, 3 years ago it was – wasn't quite like that, and we hope 3 years down the road it's even better. So just excited about what's coming back and the guys that are graduating. You know, all those seniors, every one of them has either graduated or will graduate within the next 12 months, and I think that's the ultimate goal.
Oh, for sure. You know, everybody talks about the athletics, but they are here. They need to get that education and take advantage of that as well.
Yep, absolutely.
Tech comes back the other way, and it's Collins going up, misses it, and Pannebecker can't follow as well. And it'll come back. Rocky gets the rebound as Ledeen has it. I got to work a little bit, Coach.
Oh, okay.
Ledeen has it. Gets a big screen out on top. Clayton pinches it off to Wallace. Wallace back to Ledeen. Ledeen's going to penetrate. And this one's going to be blocked coming back the other way as Pannebecker has it. And he'll take it to the hole. And we got a charge. It's going to go as Isaac Martell steps in, takes the charge against Dylan Pannebecker.
Seems like all the football guys get excited when anybody, there's a little contact, the guys diving on the ground.
Yeah, that, and they get pretty fired up when them guy cheerleaders over there can do those backflips too.
Right.
I'll tell you what.
That's right.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, I just.
It would take me two turns to get where he's at.
It'd take me 2 days to get that high to climb the ladder.
That's
to,
right.
To fall off the other side. And Ledeen's going to bring it back for Rocky. Rocky up 26-16 here. Another steal for the Ordiggers as Hughes has it. Hughes going against Ledeen. They dump it off inside. Ball's going to be stolen away, and Martell gets another steal as both these teams, a lot of turnovers here all of a sudden in this ball game. 5:45 to go in the first half. 26-16. Ledeen goes to Martell. Martell with it on the far side. Goes to Wallace. Wallace goes inside. Samuelson double-teamed inside. Oh, goes up in. Good. Strong play there by Jared Samuelson.
Boy, it seemed like every time I still followed Rocky on Twitter when I was gone, and obviously in the first couple weeks of the job, and man, that Samuelson's a heck of a player.
Yeah, he's the only time I've ever seen him shut down in 2 years was the other night against Carroll. They did a good job of actually triple teaming him whenever he got the ball inside. But yeah, just a great player, comes from a great family. Owens is going to put up the long three for the Diggers, no good. And Vining will bring it up for the Battling Bears. You talk about doing indoor football. I did indoor football up here for the Wolves. I think okay. you were around then.
That was my first year. Was there
yep.
last year.
Yep, and I enjoyed it. I really that was fun. That's fast break football is what I call that.
That is.
Collins has it on the far side. They swing it back around. Owens will have it here. He'll set things up for the Diggers. 4:26 to go as Collins puts up the free throw line. Jumper no good. England puts the putback up and good. Taylor England gets his first points of the ball game at the 4:16 mark here. One of the leading scorers for the Ore Diggers. And Ledeen has it. Drops it underneath to Samuelson. Jared having trouble getting the handle on the ball, and they're going to whistle him for a travel. It'll be turnover, and Coach Dreikosen is not going to be happy with that one.
Yeah, that was a tough call. I thought he, you know, I don't know. I'll stay out of it. I got to learn to keep my cool with the officials.
Well, these guys don't referee football. You're okay.
Oh, okay. We're good then. Well, let's let it rip.
Collins gets the ball up ahead. They all know each other, though, Coach.
Yeah, that's usually how it happens. Zebras hang out with zebras.
Ward's going to set it up out on top. They go inside Collins' free throw line, dumps it far side to Dittman. Dittman back to Ward. Hughes, Ward. Dittman, shot clock at three. Ward puts it up, no good, and the Diggers get a new shot clock on the offensive rebound. Hughes puts up the 10-footer, can't get it to fall.
Rebound
comes down Martell. Martell goes to the boy, and Brandon will bring it across. 3:22 to go here in the first half.
I like this number three. He's got some moves. He's got some shake with him.
Yeah, it's Graham
Need
Wallace.
Need to see if he can backpedal.
Graham Wallace. It's a two-pointer, 32-18. Rocky on top, their biggest lead of the night. Tech got the win back on January 5th, 75-67 up in Butte. And we got a whistle and a foul is going to go against, I believe, Grant Wallace. Yes. As Grant's going to pick up his second personal foul. Austin Payne's going to come in.
It's good to see the shorts, the short look is back.
You don't like that old look?
No.
Well, I've seen you wear some of those.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
That doesn't count, huh?
No.
Hughes with the basketball on the far side. Shot put up by Dittman is going to be, or Doer is good as Carson picks up his sixth point of the night. So, Coach, what do you think of the Frontier Conference? We know it's a tough conference in all sports, not just football, but basketball, volleyball, everything. But what's your thoughts on the Frontier Conference? You see everybody going downhill and Rocky going up, or what?
No. I hope Rocky keeps going up. We'll try to keep that going and get even better. But I think, you know, you look across the nation and there's certain teams and conferences that are the winners all the time. And, yes, they have good programs, but there's a lot of great football and basketball and everything in this conference. You know, there's not a lot of Division II schools up here, and everybody always compares, well, is Division II better than NAIA? And No, I don't think so at all. You know, I think we have players that are being recruited by Montana or Montana State. Nathan Dick, for instance, you know, he went to Montana, transferred to us, and, you know, everybody thinks, oh, he's going to transfer down and start right away, and obviously had the injury, and we're hoping for a great future with Nate. But, you know, it's a tough conference. We lost to Northern Colorado a couple years ago, and we weren't a very good football team.
Right.
But they ended up winning 7 games that year, and we won the second half.
Yeah, we could have just not played that first half. We'd have done well.
That's right. That's right. But, no, every week's a battle. Playing two teams twice is tough. I don't care who that is. The NFL, not a lot of sweeps in those with those games. And so it is tough.
Big three-pointer there by Austin Payne as he has 5 points on the night. And it's a 17-point lead, 37-20, 1:10 to go here.
I think the coaches are getting stretched over there. We got a little show at halftime we're going to put on. They don't know it yet, but.
Oh, they don't know it?
No, I don't think so.
The coaches don't know it?
Nope.
Oh.
We're going to find out real quick.
I see. I think I'm going to do some play-by-play on that. I might give me a new career going here. Or something.
I may pull the coach's card and just have them do it, or I may pull the coach's card and make sure I don't have to move and that guys are throwing me the ball when I miss, because I know there's going to be some misses.
Jared Samuelson's going to pick up the personal foul as Satchel McDonald to come in. Satchel's going to get 2 in a hurry here.
I just hope that we have enough time during halftime to complete our game. Hopefully it doesn't take more than 15, 20 minutes. I don't know how well these guys can shoot a basket.
Ward shooting well here from the free throw line tonight. You might want to recruit him, Coach.
Yep.
As he is 6 for 6 from the line tonight. All 6 of his points coming from the line. Under a minute to go, Satchel McDonald with it. Dumps it off. Martell goes baseline, kicks out to McDonald. And McDonald, free throw line jumper off the glass for 2. Satchel McDonald picks up 2 more. So you'll have all your coaching staff here, and you've started your weight program and all that good stuff. And how about any transfer students? Do you have any of them coming in on this semester, Coach?
Yeah, we had a couple come in, and, you know, it's been good. They've been bought in with everything we do. You know, we don't want to live and die by transfers, but to mix them in, to have that available need right away has been great. But we added a couple guys. Cooper Christensen from Montana Tech was here this fall. So we've had a couple guys. It's been exciting, and they're bought in and all about Rocky.
And Lucas Finding hits one at the buzzer, 41-22. Rocky on top by 19 here at halftime. And, Coach, just kind of going to turn it over to you now since we don't have any other action going on. And just kind of what you see the future here for the Batman Bears in football.
You know, hopefully keep winning, keep doing what we're doing. We're going to be the same type of offense, spread offense, and if we need to run the ball more than we throw it, great, and vice versa. So we will attack them that way defensively. Joe Dunning and Dustin Sobre and Will Papard and our defensive backs coaches will do a great job, but we're going to be aggressive. We've got a great front 7, and, you know, we'll get some recruits in to help us that, build our depth. But I think I think the future's bright, and like I said, I'm just here to keep it going and not screw it up.
Well, you know, there's you lost some pretty good seniors.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not going to sugarcoat it at all. You know that as well as anybody. But, yeah, you know, and those are always tough to lose those kids, but it's next man up.
That's right. And luckily we have guys that have had a lot of reps, but we will be younger, and that's okay. Young isn't a bad thing, but – you know, I don't think we'll ever be able to replace those guys that we lost. They did a phenomenal job. Great kids, great teammates. They worked extremely hard. Some had been here for 4 or 5 years. Some were transfers. It was a good mix. There are a lot of talented players, and that's why there was 17 NFL scouts that came through here. So, yeah, don't keep reminding me about that.
All right, I'll try not to. Not till tomorrow anyway.
That's right, that's right.
No, I was looking at your spring roster here. I know you got to go, but I got one more, couple more questions. on your spring roster on the website, it's got your seniors and then it's got your graduates. How's that work? You get those, you're just going to have all those guys come back, play another year?
We're going to try to sneak them in. We'll just change their name and sneak them in a little bit. But, no, you know, we want to keep track of them as they go, the guys who have graduated, and make sure that they're still involved with us moving forward with whatever we need, and making sure that they're finding jobs and moving on with their lives as well, and building that good alumni base for the future.
Oh, that's great. I just needed that explained to me. Because there's a couple of them there. I wouldn't mind seeing you come back.
We'd take all of them back. That's for sure. That's for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Coach, I know you got a little competition going here or
yep.
whatever, so I'm going to let you go. And
appreciate
thanks
it.
For, thanks
yeah,
for coming.
Absolutely. And if I win, I'll be back over here to gloat about all the other coaches. If I lose, I'm going home.
All right. Well, we'll let you do that.
That's right.
All right.
Thanks.
Thanks, Coach. And we'll take us a two-minute break. We'll come back, and I'll go through our halftime stats, and then we have some more activities as we are senior night here for cross country.
Elijah Boyd, Frontier Hawk Conference. Your conference runner-up, Jackson Duffy.
Coach Riley Donovan. And our time.
So the winner actually gets a meal of his choice, and the losers are going to clean the weight room. Go. Oh, God. There's Coach Corcoran. Never shot a basketball in his life. Coach Adams. Oh, my gosh. And knocks him out. He's good. All right, Coach Corcoran. Coach Sober, as you can see, Riley Donovan's not going to win. There's Coach Sober. See, Donovan's already quit. Oh, he threw the ball back. There we go. Coach Lamar is still with the bridge. All right, don't take it easy on him, guys. Oh, Coach Dougie. In the dress shoes. Coach Adams is out. Oh, come on. So great. There it is. There you go. They play me competitive. All right. Coach Donovan sees the part's going to put him out. Nope. There we go. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Oh, we helped him out there. See, you guys got to throw the ball away. Oh, yes! Let's go up on the sideline. Here we go. Down at the three. Better make it. Nope.
And a little different style of introduction of your coaching staff there by Coach Stutzring. And just a little bit of fun and a little bit of a secret, as he said there when we were talking at the end of that first half. None of those coaches knew that they were going to do that until he walked over there and told them. So we'll go ahead and get you some stats in that first half. First of all, scoring for Montana Tech. It was England with 2 points, Ward with six, Owens with five, Fitz has three, Doomer with six. They had seven turnovers, 14 rebounds, eight offensive, six defensive rebounds. They shot 23% from the floor, 22% from the three-point line, and they shot 100% from the charity stripe. For the Battling Bears, it was Betcher with 7 points. Samuelson with six. Wilmore with four. Vining with four. Ledeen with three. Martell with two. Wallace with two. McDonald with eight. And Payne with five. They had nine turnovers in the first half, 17 rebounds, two offensive, 15 defensive rebounds. They're shooting 69% from the floor, 50% from the three-point line. And they are 100% one for one from the charity stripe. Points off of turnovers, Rocky with 11-4 over Tech. Points in the paint, this is huge, 18-4 in favor of the Battling Bears. And bench points, 20-9 in favor of the Bears as well. We've had two lead changes, and we have been tied one time here in the first half. Once again, our score here at halftime, Rocky on top by 19, 41-22. We'll take us a break, come back, and get your second half going. Thank you. And we get set for our second half action here on the men's side. It's Rocky on top, 41-22, our starters for this second half. Little change for the Ordiggers. It'll be Ward, Owens, Panabecker, Dittman, and England. For the Batman Bears, it'll be the same. DuBois, Betcher, Wilmore, Vining, and Samuelson. Ordiggers get the ball to start. And the shot is going to be put up and good by Dittman on the baseline as the Ordiggers get the first points of the second half here. Shot put up. Wilmore gets the rebound, and the boy will set things up. Vining with it. Lucas hit a big shot at the end of the first half. Betcher got the first points of the ball game. Hands off to Samuelson. Jared goes up. He's going to be blocked in there by England. And Jared gets a steal, gets it up ahead as Wilmore goes up and he's fouled. As Dittman will pick up the personal foul. Craig Wilmore will go to the line to shoot some free throws. Craig's first trip to the line here tonight. And that one rattles in and out. Second one is good as Craig goes 1-for-2 from the free throw line. Rocky putting on full court pressure. As Panabecker brings it up the floor quickly, gets it out to Owens. Owens has it, goes far side to Ward. Ward swings it around and get ready for the show as Craig Wilmore goes up, and I'm sure Cody got a replay of that one for you. Ward comes back the other way. Panabecker with it. Goes to Owens. Owens going to put up the long three-pointer in and out. No good. Rebound Betcher. And Betcher comes back to the boy. Brandon gets it ahead of Vining. Vining up ahead to Jared Samuelson. And Jared gets two. And he'll go to the line to shoot one. Dittman picking up his second personal foul here. And it is up and good by Jared as he completes the old-fashioned three-point play. Panabecker with it. Goes to Ward. Ward quickly up ahead to England. And England for two, and he's going to be fouled. If the foul's going to go on Danny Betcher, that'll be his first. England picks up the two-pointer and will go to the line as he'll try for the old-fashioned three-point attempt. It's going to be off. Rebound comes down. Samuelson. Brandon DuBois brings it up. DuBois takes it down the right side, dumps it inside, and it's going to be out of bounds. It'll stay with the Bears. It'll be trying to get it into Betcher inside. DuBois will inbound it. Kicks it out to Wilmore. Wilmore with it. Goes to Vining. Vining with it out on top. Lucas goes to Betcher. Betcher goes up with the right-hander, can't finish. And the Ordiggers come back in Ward. Ward with it on top, swings it around. Panabecker 4-3, it's good. Brandon DuBois brings it up, picked up by Ward. 17:37 to go here in the second half. Bears up by 18, 47-29. Craig Wilmore with it. Goes to the boy. They go inside. Samuelson's going to be stolen away as Panabecker balances on the baseline there. Ordiggers come back with the basketball. Ward going against the boy. going to be stolen by Vining. The boy with the basketball on the far side setting up the play. And Brandon's going to put up the long three. No good. Rebound comes down England as Owens gets it to Ward. Ward goes far side. Dittman with it. Hands off to Owens. Owens going against Samuelson. Nowhere to go with the basketball. Now kicks to Dittman. Pannebecker spin move inside. It's going to be stolen by Wilmore. Gets it out to the boy as Brandon's going to lose the ball to Owens. And Owens will come back across the timeline the other way. Owens kicks out to Ward. Ward puts up the three-pointer, no good. Rebound, Samuelson. Out to Brandon, the boy. Grant Wallace set to come in, next dead ball. As well as Hughes for the Ore Diggers. The boy to Betcher. Vining with it. Vining, fadeaway shot, top of the key, and it's going to be Wilmore running down the loose ball as Samuelson takes it to the hole. It's good. Jared Samuelson picks up two. On the penetration in the baseline, he'll go to the line to shoot one. As Pannebecker picks up the personal foul, that's two on Pannebecker. Ladine will come in. After all this running in and out, Jared will be at the free throw line to shoot it. And he gets it. Grant Wallace comes in for Jared Samuelson. 50-29, Rocky on top. Collins gets the inbounds pass. They go far side to Hughes. Hughes is going to have it stolen away by Wilmore. Wilmore has it out on top. Wilmore goes to Ladine. Ladine goes baseline, goes to Brandon, the boy in the corner. And the boy hits a deep three-pointer. Brandon's first shot of points of the night. Austin Payne will come in next dead ball. Rocky's biggest lead, 53-29, 24-point lead for the Battling Bears. Owens with it, far side. Dumps it inside. Shot up, no good by Doomer. And the boy comes back the other way. Brandon with it on top. Goes to Wilmore. Wilmore goes to Betcher. Betcher with it on the far side. Danny looking to go someplace inside. Now turns around, fade away. 12-footer is good by Danny Betcher. Betcher picking up his ninth point of the night as Hughes has it on the far side. Rocky up 55-29. Hughes puts up the floater in the paint. Rebound, Grant Wallace. And Ladine comes back the other way. Ladine goes to Betcher inside. Grant Wallace going to be out of bounds off of Wallace. Satchel McDonald comes in as well as Christian Jones will come in for the Ore Diggers. Jones gets the inbounds pass. Now gets it back to Owens. Owens with it. Owens goes ahead. They go to Doomer, and Doomer's going to be fouled underneath. Austin Payne picking up the personal foul. That's his first foul. And Carson will go to the line to shoot two. His first trip to the free throw line here tonight. And the first one goes down. 55-30. 14:09 to go in the ball game. Second one is good. Ladeen takes it up the right side. It's going to go against Troy Owens. That'll be his first personal foul. As the boy gets the ball back out on top, 19 on the shot clock. The boy kicks it out to Wallace. Wallace to Payne. Payne swings it around to Ladeen. Ladeen hands it to Wallace. 6 on the shot clock. Ladeen puts up a long three-pointer. No good. Rebound, Austin Payne out to Ladeen. The boy has it out on top. He'll set things up. Grant Wallace, 18-footer, in and out, no good. Satchel McDonald gets it. It's up and good. He's fouled. Satchel McDonald picks up the offensive board and put back. Satchel with 10 points. Foul's going to go against Doomer. That'll be his third personal foul. 13:21 to go, 57-31. Rocky on top by 26. We're back after this. And Satchel McDonald will be at the free throw line trying to complete that old-fashioned three-point play. Satchel's 1-for-1 from the line tonight. Satchel completes the old-fashioned three-point play as he gets the free throw to fall. Owens with it, ball's on the floor. The boy picks it up. Brandon looks ahead to Ladeen. Ladeen goes to Satchel McDonald on a reverse layup for two more. As Satchel McDonald gets Rocky at the 60 mark, 60-31, 29-point lead here for the Batlin Bears. Shot put up, rebound Hughes out to Owens, blocked by Austin Payne, and Brandon the boy and Austin the Payne playing volleyball. Fitz comes in, Ward comes in, and England comes in for the Four Diggers. Martell will come in for the Batlin Bears. Four Diggers come back the other way. Ward with the basketball. Fitz down in the corner, now back out. Shot by Ward is up and good.
Yes.
Jones, excuse me. Satchel McDonald with it on top. And it's going to be stolen away by Jones. As he's going to, we're going to have a whistle and a foul on Satchel McDonald. Christian Jones will go to the line to shoot a couple here. His first trip to the line tonight. Second one is going to roll in for Jones. 60-34, 12:08 to go here in the ball game. Satchel McDonald goes to Ladine. Ladine has it. Ladine gets the free throw line, goes back to McDonald. Satchel takes it to the hole, up with the left hand. It's good. England comes back the other way. No, excuse me, that is not England. Gets the basket to fall, is fouled. Yes, it was England. Nice move in there by Tater England, taking it to the hole. As Wilmore will pick up the personal foul. Excuse me, Wallace. Doomer completes the old-fashioned three-point play. 62-37. Satchel McDonald with the basketball on the far side. Goes out to Martell. Martell finds Austin Payne underneath for two. Nice pass by Martell to Payne. 64-37. Ward with it out on top. Goes to Fitz, down on the baseline. Now they swing it to England on middle. England goes up, it's good. Tater England picks up two in the paint. 11:02 to go in the ball game. Rocky up 64-39. McDonald goes to Austin Payne. Austin Payne hits the deep three-pointer. Ward with it out on top. Rocky going 2-3 zone defense here. Ward pulls up, elbows up, and Ladine picks up his second personal foul. Nate Ward will go to the line. Nate is 6-for-6 from the line tonight. And he's now 7-for-7. All seven of his points coming from the charity stripe. Ward, the second one is good as well as he goes 8-for-8 from the charity stripe here tonight. And Satchel McDonald will bring it up for the Battling Bears. Satchel with it. Satchel goes far side, Martell. Martell puts it on the floor, goes to a hole. Isaac Martell on the penetration for two. Nice drive there by Isaac. Fitz has it, kicks it back out to Ward to Fitz. They swing it in the corner. Shot is going to be put up, going to be long, that shot by Mighty. And the Bears come back. 10:04 to go here in the ballgame. Rocky 69-41. DeAndre Bryant going to come in next dead ball. Grant Wallace gets it to Satchel McDonald. Satchel to Grant. three-pointer in the corner. It's good. Grant Wallace hits three. 72-41, 9:37 to go in the ball game. Rocky on top of Tech. Ward with the basketball. Ward, three-pointer, top key, in and out, no good. Wallace with the rebound. And Ladine will bring it up. Isaac Martell. Out to Wallace. Grant back to Martell. Wallace, they swing it around to Ladine. Ladine with it out on top. Ladine, three-pointer, top of the key is good. Clayton Ladine hits a deep three, his second three of the night. 75-41, Rocky on top, 8:58 to go in the ball game. Just getting our stat sheet here, and Rocky shooting a clip of 67% from the floor, and the Ordigger shooting 29%. Pretty much tells the story on the scoreboard here in the ballgame. It'll be Tech basketball in the backcourt. As Jones will inbound it, get it to Fitz. Fitz will bring it up. Both coaches basically got their benches on the floor here, and I think it'll probably stay that way the final 8.5 minutes of this ball game. Satchel McDonald brings it up. Satchel out to Austin Payne. Grant Wallace with it. Back to Satchel. McDonald to Wallace. And Grant is going to go to the line to shoot some free throws. Doomer picks up his fourth personal foul. And Grant will go to the line to shoot a couple. And Grant's first free throw is up and good. As Grant has 6 points on the evening. Second one is good as well for Grant as he goes 2 for 2 from the line. 77-41 our score, 8:25 to go in the ball game. Fitz with it, goes far side to Jones. Jones. And the corner shot is going to be up, no good, that by Dittman. As McDonald comes back the other way. Ordigger stay in a man-to-man defense. Get it into Austin Payne. Austin back to Satchel McDonald. It's going to go out of bounds. And it'll be Ordinger basketball as that is off the hands of Satchel McDonald. Nick Fitz brings it up. They get it in the high post to Hughes. Now they swing it back. Fitz on top. His three-pointer going to be off. Rebound Payne. Austin will get it out to Satchel McDonald. And Satchel will bring it up across timeline. Satchel goes to Wallace. Grant puts up the three-pointer right side. No good. And Austin Payne. I'm not sure what the call was. We got a timeout on the floor. They'll stretch it to a media timeout. I'm guessing the ball was just out of bounds. That's the only thing. .725 to go as the Ordinger will bring it up in the backcourt. Rocky on top, 77-41. They get it into Hughes, high post. Hughes double team, kicks it out to Jones. They swing it around Fitz. Fitz three-pointer, top the key is good.
Three-pointer, Nick Fitz.
Nick hits his second three-pointer of the night, 77-44. DeAndre Bryant with the ball. Bryant swings it around, Martell. Grant Wallace for three, and this one's short, and it's gonna go out of bounds. I believe it's gonna stay with Rocky, yep.
Media
timeout on the floor, 6:50 to go, 77-44, Rocky. Cody, do you remember when you used to be able to do that? .650 to go in our ball game. Rocky on top, 77-44, as they've blown this one open in the second half. Our score at halftime was 41-22. Martell inbound the basketball, gets it into Bryant. DeAndre has it out on top. And this one's going to be stolen by Jones, and Martell's going to pick up the personal foul. Bryant with the basketball on the far side. Tech comes back the other way. Hughes with the basketball. And the shot's going to be up and good. Three-pointer by Christian Jones. Seventy-seven, 47, 6:04 to go in the ball game. Rocky on top in this one, in total control, as both coaches have had their benches on the floor here pretty much. DeAndre Bryant brings the ball off the floor for the Bears. Goes to Martell. Martell from the far side. No good. Rebound comes down to England, and Fitz will bring it up across the timeline. Fitz, three-pointer, top of the key. It's good. Nick Fitz. It's his third three-pointer of the night. Going to have a whistle and a foul. Going to go against Drew Hughes. Carson Doomer coming back in for England.
On the line for your Maryland Bears. And a one-on-one opportunity. Number 5, Isaac Martell.
Martell at the line. First trip of the line tonight for Isaac. And it's no good. Tech comes down with the rebound. Fitz with the ball. Fitz penetrates. Takes it to the hole. It's going to be stripped by Bryant. And they're going to say it's off of Nick Fitz. Rocky basketball in the backcourt. Bryant brings it up. Bryant kicks it out to Satchel McDonald. They swing it around. Austin Payne with it on top. Go inside Grant Wallace. Wallace goes to work inside. Wide open on the jump hook. Can't finish. Satchel McDonald with the putback for two. Nick Fitz comes back the other way, 79-50, Rocky on top. Fitz goes far side to Dipman. Hughes goes baseline. We got a whistle and a foul on the baseline. Going to go against DeAndre Bryant. Cody Lyles coming into the ball game for the Ore Diggers. And he'll replace Dittman. As Drew gets the first one to go. And the second one up and good as well. Bryant with the basketball at the right side, guarded by Fitz. Goes to Martell. Grant Wallace, they go inside Austin Payne. It's going to go out of bounds. It'll be Rocky basketball underneath as DeAndre Bryant will inbound the basketball. Bryant gets it into McDonald. Satchel with it on the far side. McDonald goes to Grant Wallace. Grant with it out on top. Hands off to Bryant. Bryant, free throw line, step back jumpers, no good. And the rebound comes down to Doomer as the Ore Diggers get the ball up the floor quickly. Hughes has it to Fitz. Fitz has it to Jones. And we got a whistle and a foul. Going to go against Isaac Martell away from the basketball. And Doomer will go up the line for the Ore Diggers. As Carson gets the first one to fall. Second one off the front iron, rebound, Austin Payne. Satchel McDonald up ahead to Isaac Martell. Martell back to Austin Payne for three. This one's going to be long. Fitz with the rebound. Cody Lyles with the ball, drops it down inside, and it's going to be stolen away by Satchel McDonald. And the Bears come back the other way. McDonald with it out front. Goes to Grant Wallace. Wallace hands off to McDonald. Back to Wallace. Grant dumps off Bryant into Austin Payne. Austin in the post. Turnaround jumper from six is good by Austin Payne. 81-53. Rocky on top. 2:57 to go in the ballgame. Jones with the basketball on the far side. Jones goes to Mitty. Mitty with it. Mitty puts up the three-pointer. Front iron, no good. Rebound picked up DeAndre Bryant. And Bryant goes to Martell. And Martell up for two on the assist from Bryant. Tough shot by Isaac to make that a dead run. Catch the ball and put it in the hole. Ward and Nick Fitz, three-pointer right side, no good. Bryant gets the rebound. DeAndre goes to Martell. They swing it out. Goes to Grant Wallace. Grant can't finish on the spin move as Jones will come back the other way. Under 2 minutes to go in the ballgame. Jones goes up, and we got a whistle and a foul. Austin Payne picking up the personal foul as Jones will go to the line. First one will be off the back iron.
Hey.
And the second one is up and good by Jones. Martell gets the ball on the front court, far side. Now goes to Grant Wallace, to Bryant. Bryant with the ball goes to Austin Payne. Satchel McDonald, and Satchel's going to step on the sideline. It'll be turnover to the Ortigers. Fitz comes back. 1:30 to go in the ball game. Doomer with it, and Carson's going to be fouled on the shot. He'll go up the line and shoot two, as Grant Wallace going to pick up his fourth personal foul. And Carson will go back to the free throw line. He is 4 of 5 tonight from the line. He'll be shooting two. First one is up and good, 83-55, 1:20 to go in the ballgame. Second one, front iron, Austin Payne with the rebound. Satchel McDonald brings it back the other way. Satchel kicks out to Grant Wallace, top of the key for three. 86-55, Rocky on top, Fitz with it. Goes to Mighty. Excuse me, that's Lyles, going to be stolen away. Satchel McDonald gets it up ahead to Austin Payne, and Austin puts down the flush. 88-55. Lyles puts it up. Grant Wallace with the rebound. Shot clock is shut off, and I think this will finish her out. Rocky 88, Montana Tech 55. As DeAndre Bryant will dribble it out, goes to Grant Wallace, and Grant puts it up from deep as the shot clock was going down. And that'll be our final. Rocky comes away with the win, 88-55. We'll get our stats and wrap this one up. The guy in the green shirt. And our stats for this final on the men's side. It was Rocky on top tonight, 88-55 in the men's action. Some scoring, first of all, for the Ortigers from Montana Tech. It was Pannebecker with 3 points, England with nine, Ward with eight, Owens with five, Jones with seven, Fitz with nine, Dittman with two, Doomer with 10, Hughes with two. They had 16 turnovers, 25 rebounds, 10 offensive, 15 defensive rebounds, 30% from the floor, 26% from the three-point line, and 78% from the charity stripe. For the Battling Bears, it was Betcher with 9 points, Samuelson with 12, the boy with three, Wilmore with seven, Vining with four, Ladine with six, Martell with six, Wallace with 10, McDonald with 17, and Payne with 14. They had 18 turnovers, 39 rebounds, nine offensive, 30 defensive rebounds. They shot 61% from the floor, 40% from the three-point line, and 78% from the charity stripe. Rocky led at halftime in this one by the score of 41-22 and come away with a victory, 88-55. And for the, hey, be careful what you unplug, because I'm still on. Be careful.
Be careful what you unplug, because I'm still on.
Rocky gets the win here, 88-55. And the women's side, it was 74-53 in favor of the Battling Bears. So Rocky gets a sweep over Montana Tech here tonight. Our next games will be next Thursday night. The women will play at 5:30 and the men at 7:30 as Montana Western will come to town to take on the Battling Bears here at the Fortin Center. And then on Saturday we'll play Lewis Clark State, and those start times will be 3 o'clock and 5 o'clock. Want to thank everyone for watching tonight, and want to thank Cody and the crew upstairs for doing their job up there. And until Thursday night, have a great Battling Bear weekend.